Good day, guys. Welcome to I'm a Daddy with Nathaniel Evans. Today I have a great topic we can talk about. And it just came to me, you know, as I read, as I write, as I study, more things come to me in this world to share on this platform. You know, and everything is not scripted. You know, it's, you know, moving in the moment, moving according to real time. So with this, I'll actually introduce my topic. If energy doesn't roar, unraveling the secret forces of the universe, right? What does that mean? You know, how do we unravel the secret forces of the universe? And how do we ensure that our energy roars, right? What does that look like? You know, are we, you know, because on my caption, I actually put like a lion, you know, with the word energy in his mouth to actually show that, you know, it has to come from within the depths of who we are, right? Who we are in the world, what we want to become in the world, how we allow ourselves to be identified by the world, you know, and actually bringing forth these new changes for ourselves in the world and tapping into new concepts, you know, new energy, right? A believing that, I don't like this shit, believing that we are able to surpass things that's in this life that's actually designed to basically like decrease us, right? The roar of our energy. That life source, where does it come from, and why do we need it? You know, listen to a lot of concepts out here, and it shows that we have to be able to not just tap in, but want to tap in, want to have the opportunities to tap in, and to know that, you know, there is no quick fix. You know, to know that we have to put the work in, and as we put the work in, this is where the roar comes from, is our explosiveness, is our desire to bring forth change, our desire to make anew old things, right? And stepping outside of our own path, you know, of what we have created. That oomph of our lives, right? Those principal thoughts, these principal concepts, and not just being lackadaisical in our approaches. Not allowing things like to just, you know, living a life without meaning, so to speak. You know, this is really purposeful for who we are. And wow, man. As I think about this life and as I think about a lot of different changes that's taking place, you know, we got different wars and stuff taking place. And I see that humanity is fighting, right, to find this place in the world, that we're fighting to know more about our lives than we actually know. And how do we actually get to this place of comfortability? How do we get to this place of being aware of our lives? Like, hold on for 1 second, guys. You know, I'm not on camera, but I'm still here to speak. You know, and it'd have been great to have a guest for today to tap in, to actually bring awareness about this certain topic. Because, you know, some of us, we have great energy in the world. And, you know, we do our best to tap in to the world, And, you know, how do we really, really hold ourselves accountable for the energy of who we are? That roar, that, yeah, I'm gonna get it, right? Nothing's gonna stop me. You know, I think I found a solution, you know what I'm saying, to the issue I was dealing with. You know, I'm able to project myself into new spaces, you know, connect with new people, have different value systems for my life, right? How do I get into that? Right? How do I actually become this person that actually believes in all the different mysteries of me, right? This is my belief, right? How do I get into this belief system, right? How do I channel myself on a higher plane? And how do I connect with those, the others that I need to connect with in my life so I can store up this new profound energy for my life? Am I content with the life I have now and the direction that is going in? Am I able to bring forth new changes and new levels of awareness? Or is this just it? Is it, it is what it is type energy? You know, it's, you know, this always happens to me. I'm always in a certain space, right? Unraveling the silent forces, unraveling the silent forces of the universe. What's the silent forces that we're talking about? Can anybody chime in? Can anybody, you know, help me understand what are some of the silent forces that we have in the universe that if we tap in, allow us to roar and allow us to get to different levels of plateau? Anybody? You know, I'm always here for discussions. I'm always here if people want to come in and chime in, you know, to what I'm doing, just send me a message and I'll send you the link and we can actually just have a conversation. You know, life is about moving in real time and moving in the moment. You know, yeah, we write our goals out, we write our plans out. We got all different types of strategies, right? But how do we implement them? In real time, that's how. Right? It's not going to just come to us out of nowhere, you know. We have to really be in a place of our lives to really start channeling what we really want out of this life, right? And to be that roaring giant, be that, you know, instigator, right? So to speak, for who we are. And just being responsible, just being accountable to this new approach that you want for your life, right? And knowing that without a shadow of a doubt that you can get it done, that you can actually do this, that there's no question about it, that there's something that's deep within us that's waiting to come out. It's waiting to roar like a lion. It's waiting to show us that, yo, bro, you thought you knew about life. You thought you knew what was going on, but you really did. Let me show you something. Right. Let me give you a clearer view or deeper insight into what you actually can become and what you actually can do. There are things that we get caught in that's mediocre. We got the same rituals and the same patterns, and those same rituals and the same patterns come with the same things. And it's like you're in this circle, right? And you're trying to get out this circle, but it's like this circle is like it's continuous, right? You got to wait for the right moment. So you could jump out the circle, but it's like, if I get snagged while I'm trying to jump out, I'm not going to be able to make it, right? So it's also this fear that we have that will allow us to stay content in spaces that are not allowing us to grow. Think about this. There are spaces in this time that we have created or we're allowed to be created around us. That's the circle. It's continuous. It's not allowing us to shift into our different utopias of awareness, you know, to channel new thoughts and new concepts, to meet new people, to go new places. Might get stuck just watching Netflix or Hulu and things of that nature. Might get caught up on your favorite show or your favorite song, things of that nature. When you know deep down within your spirit, within your heart, that you got other things to do. You have other work to get done. And, you know, as we go into the world, it's like, you know, we want to take ownership of things. There's so many things that's out here that people have come to a level of possessing. They won't let nobody else help them with it. They won't let anybody else in the room. It belongs to them, and it belongs only to them, right? And that reality actually locks us in to spaces that we are supposed to be able to surpass. The reality of owning this or owning that, you know, I own my husband, I own my wife, I own my children. You know, I was on the train the other day and it was some weird energy where the woman was telling the children, don't sit down until I tell you to sit down. You only do what I tell you to do. And it was like that energy will ride with those children for a long time. Because now they get to a point that it's like, I have no autonomy, right? I'm controlled by this woman or this man. They tell me what to do, how to do it, where to do it. If I share my concepts or beliefs, you know, they evaluate in a way where I'm basically like might be outside the picture of the evaluation, because sometimes people know more about you than you know about yourself. And it's actually finding yourself in these different spaces for your life where you know that you have the ability to roar. And not only do you have the ability to roar, you're supposed to roar in your life. You're supposed to break through barriers and break through realities that are not basically increasing you in life, are not allowing you to be at peace in your life, you know, to sleep peaceful at night, to wake up with a new burst of energy, of peace, of harmony, you know, being embraced by the core values and the core substance of who you are. And as we move in spaces like that, we wind up diminishing over time, right? Who we were 5 years ago and what we did 5 years ago and things of that nature, we're not able to do those things anymore. We don't even identify with that person anymore. It's, in a way, we got to shift out of our space. We let things into our world, people, places, or things that do not have our best interests at heart. We may work for money, but we don't work for life. We don't work for peace. We don't work for happiness. We don't work for to solidify who we are and what we are and what we want our legacies to be in this life. Sometimes we live as if we're going to live forever, right? And I read a passage yesterday on Facebook when a man was actually talking about that. He was actually talking about the fact that he said, we're all going to die. This is basically how he said it. Like, there's nothing that we can do about it. And we can't perceive that because we're not a part of that reality. Even though we see it every day, we witness it every day, we're like, oh my God, that's so bad. But we don't really grasp the concept of life and death in that aspect to the point where if I'm going to move on or transition anyway, why wouldn't I do the best I can do with this life? Why wouldn't I propel myself to actually move myself out of any sense of quicksand or any level of bondage that I see have taken place against me? Why am I not in that space where I can be like, you know what? It's all or nothing, man. You know, let me rock this out. Let me lock myself in. It's time for me to have a new level of synergy for who I am and who I want to become. Right? If I want to be in a room, I got to put myself into the room. And if I want to be known as a certain individual, I have to be known as an individual by the things that I do, by my deeds, right? And how do we get there? Do we get there on our own? I think that's part of it. I think that the substance of who we are actually resonates within us. But I also think that it's to be pulled out of us, like Socrates and Aristotle was suggesting, to pull these things out of us by connecting with others, by connecting with other type of energies, by learning our place in the universe and actually be seeking to become one with actually who we are and what we are to become in the land. And like I said earlier, there is no quick fix, but there is one there as we tap in. When we tap in, then we find the fixes of who we are. Then we find those components that make us who we are as a people, and then we're able to step out of our own way. I think that's one of the things I've been seeing, that the roadblocks that's in front of us actually a lot of times be created by us. We put those things in place and we don't really perceive them to be that way. We think that other people put them there, or we allow other people to put those things there. But we actually took the time out to allow those roadblocks to form right in front of our eyes. And as they form, we don't really get to be who we need to be in the world because we got all these blockages that's right there. And they won't move by themselves. So it's like if I'm driving and a tree falls in front of my car, I got to jump out of my car and the tree is too heavy, I can't move it. I'm about to call for help and say, yo, man, this tree just dropped on the road. I can't get my car by. I can't go around a tree. I need somebody to come and move this tree for me so I can keep moving. Some of the things that fall in front of us are extremely heavy. We can't lift them up with our whole might, right? We wish that we had mind control, we could just pick it up and just fly it across the sea like they said they created the pyramids with the mind. But is that really the case? When we find something that's in front of us, do we actually tap into the true core of who we are, to find out how will I be able to move this thing out of my way? What would be the purpose and the value of you moving things out your way that are not allowing you to roar with your true energy, that are not allowing you to unravel the silent forces of the universe? What would be the cause of that? What is the value system? And I'm asking everybody, what is the value system of moving things out of your way that actually depletes your energy and allows you not to tap into the universe on a higher plane? What does that look like, right? How is that value for who you are? You know, it's, you know, as me being a marketer, you know, me being into advertisement, and even in, you know, into politics, I get to see that there are a lot of other forces at work other than me just being there. I have to tap into other people. I have to have other people help me with these things and these things because I don't know all things, right? I'm not a master marketer or a master advertiser. You know, I'm not the ultimate political giant in the world, right? I'm learning as I go in a lot of these things. And there's some people have took the time out to learn the things that I need to know. And I actually have to go to them to know those things and to actually help me to actually accomplish those things, because I have to do other things with my time, my energy, that's according to my strength and my abilities. I cannot turn around and try to rob another man of his gifts and his value systems that he's worked on because I don't have the economics to work with that individual, or because I don't have the insight that I need to actually be that person. And that's when I start understand that I have the ability to roar to a higher level when I tap into the core of who I am and what I represent into the world. You know, it's an easy thing to just deny certain gifts that's in life, and even our own, you know, but valuing and seeing the value of other people and what they have to offer in your life and how they can actually increase you in spaces of your life that you're not even aware of is the beginning step of getting to your true power. Actually meaning that, move things out your way that are not for your mastery, right? If others have mastered things, allow them to master those things. You tap into the things that you need to master for your life, and you have to put things on the back burner, or, you know, until you're able to actually sustain relationships with others and actually invest in those relationships. And that's exactly what you have to do. You know, patience is a virtue, and understanding who we are and what we are, what we can actually become, is a part of that patience. Think about this, right? Our energy flows just like the river, you know, just like the sea, in the direction that it's supposed to go in. And then sometimes when a strong wind comes in, it'll push it, the energy into a different space. It pushes the waves and the flow of the sea or the rivers go somewhere else. But once that strong wind is over with, everything goes back to normal. Everything starts going according to the cycle that was created to go in. And we have to be able to do the same thing. Yes, there are times we're going to get pushed out of the way. And we're not going to be able to, like, oh, wow, get my foot in. Where am I going? I don't even know where I'm going. I'm being taken somewhere, and I don't even know where I'm being taken to. But after you go through that journey, after you learn the lessons that you need to learn and the insight that you need to learn from that journey, go back to your course, get back on your path. You know, stand as a giant in true form on the earth, according to your heart, your spirit, your mind. Allow nothing to derail you and stop you from doing what you need to do. And without that raw energy that taps into the universe, that force that allows it to be explosive, right? How do we get there? How do we learn the value system of who we are without tapping into that value system and without actually holding that value system to high regard and learning from that value system that actually belongs to us? How do we do it? These are things to contemplate. You know, every week I come on here and I speak about different topics. I bring different guests on. And every week I learn something new. And I see that we're all striving to find our place in the world. You know, some of us believe our place in the world is economics. You know, some of us believe that it's having power and control. You know, some of us believe that it's actually creating a spiritual relationship with the Most High. You know, some of us believe that, you know, we don't care about nothing and nobody, just us against the world type energy. And depending on who you are and actually how you perceive in your life, this is what energy is going to come to you. This is how you're going to be perceived. This is how you're going to be projected into the world. You know, this will be a cause of you not elevating or elevating in life. It all comes from within. The things that we find without are actually without. You know, money is a great tool. I need some more too, just like everybody else. But I've learned something too, that money doesn't reside within you. The physical money they have, but the true essence of money resides within you. When you tap into your core values and your belief systems, right? You're able to get to those things that you need to get to materialize them into true form. They have to exist within you first before you're able to go out there and get those things and treat yourself well and treat yourself better. Don't look at your life as if it's meaningless because you don't have this or you don't have that, or you didn't achieve this or you didn't achieve that. I've been through some rocky roads in this world, from professional relationships to personal relationships, you know, and I've learned a few things along the way. I'm responsible and I'm accountable for who I am and what I do. You know, the places I show up at, I showed up there. It's not a mystery. You know, I don't need TV to tell me that I was at a certain rally or I was talking to a certain individual or I was doing a certain thing. I know what I was doing because I was there. I placed myself in that room. I took my energy and I submitted myself to this place, to this cause, because I believe that certain causes are greater than me. I was on a Zoom the other day and I had to say that to someone that, you know, I understand that you're working on this project. I get it. But understand that this project is greater than you. It really has nothing to do with you, even though you're putting, you know, pen to paper, even though you're doing typing, even though, you know, you're sitting in boardrooms and y'all coming up with certain concepts and realities and strategic planning. It doesn't belong to you. There are other people that's going to eat up that plate that you're creating that you may never even eat off. You may create plates that you never even use in your life, and other people are going to benefit from those plates. You may say that plate you created is beneath you, but it doesn't matter because you're not eating up the plate. And you can't eat up 1,000 plates. You can't eat up 1,000,000 plates. You need a million people, 1,000 people to help you eat up those plates. And actually putting plates out there for others to be able to enjoy, to benefit from, is a beautiful thing. That energy that you put out there for others to benefit from actually comes back to you. It actually increases you and allows you to know that you got this, that you are the purpose of your change, that you have the ability to store up new energy and new value for your life, and that nothing can really stop you unless you allow it not to resonate within you. It's taking time to understand who you are through prayer, through fasting, through meditation. You know, through taking journeys in your life, through going through your pitfalls and your ups and downs according to existence, and learning that as you maneuver through all these different processes that you're actually going to be moving through, that not all of them are going to want you to succeed. Every process you go through is not going to be for your liking. It's not going to be for your increase. Some things that you do is only going to be done for others. You know, some of the things that we do are selfless acts, right? But not according to, you know, just being in the world that they're selfless. You know, it's actually understanding that even though you may not get retribution for those things in the world that you put in the world, that energy of who you are and what you presented to the world at that time still exists. It still has a purpose. It still has a value to it. The gift of life is actually you being a gift of life, not only towards yourself, but also towards others. And I had a conversation with a friend of mine today, not too long ago. And, you know, she was speaking about, you know, systems that she's working on and things that she's trying to bring to fruition, you know. And I was telling her that, yeah, I get it. I understand that you feel you have to do these things. She said, yeah, because this is my concern. It's not, it doesn't belong to anybody else. And I said, well, you know, when you look at it from a metaphysical standpoint, it's really not your concern. It's a concern of other people. If you're putting systems in place that are designed to save life, just know this. You're not going to be around for eternity to see how those systems actually protected life and designed life and motivated life to move to the next level. You create a system right now, and in 2 centuries, it's going to help another man and woman that you're never going to lay eyes on, because you're not going to be here for that, right? That love of life is the gratitude of a positive system that actually resides within you, a positive energy source that resonates within you that's waiting to explode, to come out like, yo, what's up, guys? Let's do this, right? It's telling you, it's pushing you outside of your comfort zone, and it's allowing you to be free in your life that others cannot understand. Freedom of self, that's energy. That's your true energy. This is the energy that allows you to roar regardless of what you're going through, what situations are actually before you, to roar out of situation and to see that you are the true light for your life. Right? Even with this system right here, I've been seeing that, you know, the resolution has actually been kind of crazy. I've been seeing light going in and out, right? It has nothing to do with me. I've been actually working on this system for like over a year now, and there's been some real strategic problems. But at the end of the day, I'm not going to allow it to stop me. I'm just going to keep roaring through my process. I'm going to keep channeling through my problem and keep challenging this process until I find another system that's going to work better for me and allow me to interact and treat myself better as well as others, right? So as we start on our path and as we start on our journey, I'm going to leave you with this, that we are responsible for continuing the energy source that allowed us to get started in the first place. And regardless of what actually comes in our path, actually stops us in our path and to uproot us from our path or put stumbling blocks in front of our path, we have to know how to duck, dodge, and weave, right? Past all these different things. We have to be able to do it because it is our energy responsibility, the responsibility of our energy to create new energy, right? And to bring forthright the energy that we created to start whatever project we start on, whether it might be writing a book, singing a new song, whatever it may be, you know what I mean? Creating your first play, going on your first job interview. What is that energy going to look like for you when you tap in? It's going to be amazing. That's what it's going to be. You know, it's like that moment, right? That you can't define and you can't explain to nobody else, but you know it's there and you know you felt it, right? I've been on spaces where I feel energy go through me. I feel like something attached itself onto me, you know, like a positive energy and something like, wow, that was kind of deep, man. I got moved by that, right? And it caused me to speak in a certain way or move in a certain way or, you know, do things in a certain way because I am responsible for my energy. I am responsible for my energy. I definitely am responsible for my energy. And how I use it would allow me to create or don't create in the world. And who doesn't want to create? Who doesn't want to be at their highest potential in life? Who doesn't want to see life on a higher level and be connected on a higher level? Who? I can't speak for these people. They have to speak for themselves, right? We have to learn as a people that we have a greater value system that resides within us, just like the value system of the universe. The sun, the moon, the star, they all have a value system. You know what I'm saying? The air we breathe and things like that, they all have a value system to preserve us, to keep us alive, where we can actually come to our true potential. We got things here that's preserving us, so now we have to preserve ourselves in turn. You know what I'm saying? As contribution and as recognition and as homage to those things in the world. And with that, guys, I'm going to sign off. Hope y'all enjoyed my conversation. And I'll actually see y'all next week, hopefully with a guest. Peace, guys, and have a great day. Tune into IAMTHEDATA. Please subscribe, help me grow. I'm on YouTube, Facebook, you know, Amazon, Apple, things of that nature. Help me grow, help me move forward, help me get my message out there to many different people. And with that, I sign off. Peace.